I think that I need to say something. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. So I can see the music, and I don't really need to see my hands that much, so
okay.
I think
okay.
It'll be good.
Good to know.
Yes.
Yep.
Thank
just
you.
Want to check again.
Thank you.
Because your aura there will be all different.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Is this set the way it should be, or?
Their robes have to be there, yeah.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, sorry about the tape. They. Well, I told them to try to not touch it. They're gonna, yeah, and then they're gonna come in once the house is pretty full. At like 6:55, they're gonna come in and sit in this box.
Okay, so, all right.
So the tape might be somewhere random.
When can we open the house?
No.
No, I just assume, unless you got somebody to guard this, I'll see if I can find it.
Well, there's already signs on it.
There are some signs. But
yeah, people will not read those.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, they need to know why. That's why we're taping it. But if we don't tape it off, they're going to go, oh, well, I didn't see. Well, I'm not getting up now. I'll be right back. We're good.
Good evening, and welcome to the Songs of Nature and Humanity Choir Concert. Tonight you will hear our 9th through 12th grade choirs singing a variety of songs they worked really hard to prepare. Our first group is our Madrigal Choir. This is a group of individuals who auditioned out of concert choir or another large ensemble here at the school. They meet before school for a limited amount of time. They've prepared 3 pieces for you. The first song they will be singing is An Irish Blessing. This is a traditional song from Ireland that wishes well on people who are leaving or taking a journey. The song was originally written in the traditional Irish language, Gwalga, but is now most commonly sung in English. This blessing dates back to pre-Christian times, in fact, to Celtic times. This piece is deeply connected to nature, as you will hear. Enjoy.
Our next song is El Grillo, Italian for the cricket. It was written and composed by Josquin des Prez around 1505. Des Prez is often considered by music scholars to be the first master of the polyphonic High Renaissance style. This lively madrigal is in the style of a frottola, a comic song for 3 or 4 voices. It was sung for parties and gatherings in the Renaissance.
Thank you.
The next song the Madrigals will be singing is called Weep, O My Eyes by John Bennett. This is another madrigal from the 16th century. The vocal lines are supposed to imitate weeping, as the lyrics are very deep and capture a strong sense of loss and sadness. The 9th grade choir is coming on stage now, so. Sorry, I thought I had something written for right now, and I don't. That's.
The Symphony of Night is a poem converted to song by Mark Patterson. It represents the beauty of spring and the magical qualities of nightfall with a starlit sky. With the unique usage of the sopranos and altos breaking away from each other to make a lovely mishmash of music.
Thank you. The next song we will sing is Zoom Golly Golly, composed by Dan Schwartz. It was a traditional Hebrew song that Israel workers sang. This is a rhythmic style work song they sang while on the fields. This song was created to help relieve the pain and stress of these Israel workers. This folk song was known for being passed down for many generations. It is still sung to this day. I hope you enjoy this next song we are going to sing for you tonight.
Our next song is a piece we spent a lot of time on. It is a higher level song like one you'd hear our concert choir sing. But Miss Card had faith and we learned it with all of the two-part harmonies. I'm introducing When I Am Silent by Joan Varner. The piece is about remembrance of the children in Auschwitz and other children who died during the 1940s. Joan describes his experience touring Auschwitz as haunting, looking at so many pictures of young boys and girls who had to go through that, saying they reminded him of his students. There was one picture in particular that drove him to this piece. Looking at it made him think of what her life would have been like if she had the chance. So he wrote this song with that little girl and other children who had their childhood ripped away from them in mind, saying, "Sing it for them."
Thank you. You just heard our ninth grade choir. This group has grown so much this year as individuals and as musicians, and I could not be more proud of them. Those harmonies you heard took a very long time, and they all put a lot of work into it. Our next and final group is the concert choir. We are starting with a piece called Moyilla Mar, which is traditional Irish gwalga. We actually purchased a Bowron drum and had planned to play it tonight, but our percussionist was unable to be here. So we are making do with what we have. It will not be the Bowron tonight, but that is what we practiced with and learned about and dove into the culture with. So it's being substituted tonight by our wonderful accompanist, Miss Feline.
Shemulich moyilamar, shemohesayilamar, ni for as fain and tuana shain, oh, who kicken moyilamar. Shemulech moyilamar, shemohesayilamar, ni for as fain an tuana shain, oh, who gigan moyilamar.
next piece is Ain't That Good News. It is an African-American spiritual that was sung during the slave days as hope for the future and a way to communicate with other slaves. During the months we spent learning the song, we really dug deep into the meaning behind spirituals and how they were passed down through generations. Most were simply improvised and passed down folk-like from family to family. So please enjoy this written spiritual by Mose Hogan.
The song Requiem, written by Eliza Gilkison and composed by Craig Hella Johnson, it was written in memory of the victims of the Asian tsunami of 2004. The tsunami claimed the lives of 227,898 people, and many more were displaced. The song pleads for comfort in a desperate time. The phrasing in the song resembles the waves with the dynamic growth and decay. Please keep everyone affected by this tragedy in your heart as you listen to our performance.
Thank you.
I want to thank you all again for being here. I want to thank our wonderful accompanist, Emily Valine, and the extra tasks that she picked up, for coming in and working with us, and the CHS staff who has helped us prepare for tonight and been so supportive of me in this crazy first year of teaching. I want to thank our auditorium manager, John Justad, for the rehearsal time he spent with us to make everything for tonight perfect. Most importantly, I want to thank these wonderful students here tonight. They are extremely hardworking, caring, thoughtful people, and I am lucky that I get to spend time with them each day and watch them grow as musicians and humans. I hope you enjoy our last piece.
Our next piece is called MLK. It was written by the band U2 and was arranged by Bob Chilcott for choir. In honor of Martin Luther King Jr.'s legacy, MLK entered college at the age of 15, became a preacher at the age of 25. He was stabbed on September 20th, 1958. On December 3rd, 1963, he shook hands with the President of the United States. Over the span of his life, he was arrested a total of 29 times. MLK was a fighter. He fought for the dreams he knew were possible and the people he knew could live them. He was also a hero to many. He stood tall, even in the face of death. MLK is most famous for his "I Have a Dream" speech. U2 originally wrote this piece with MLK's dreams in mind. Sleep. Sleep tonight, and may your dreams be realized.
Sleep tonight, and may your dreams be realized. If the thundercloud passes round,